Okay. Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Reference, and welcome back to another video. I don't know what just happened. I literally. Okay. Okay, cool. I just need to bring the OBS thing up just in case, so I want to see. Anyway, this is gonna be a Stories from the Outlands. This is new. Normally, they have the standard YouTube, what's it called? Like, countdown or whatever. But I don't really know anything about this. Stories from the Outlands, other than it's probably gonna relate to the new legend. I know the teasers have been coming around, and all I know about all of that, oh my goodness, the balance of my camera, is that essentially Salvo is a fringe world in the Outlands. And recently it got inducted into the Syndicate, which is like the big thing that runs the game and whatnot. And I feel like I should mention, it's probably because I feel like the Syndicate pulled some CIA stuff. And undermine the government of Salvo in order to put their own people in. But of course, we don't know that for sure. I just have a gut feeling considering. Anyway, this is kind of reminiscent of when Apex first launched, if I'm gonna be honest. I wonder why they decided to be so fancy with it this time. But yeah, soon I will raise this back up a little bit. Because I wanna make sure that the audio is balanced. Also, ignore my hair. Ignore, honestly. The face cam is just here so that you can see my physical reaction, but I don't think I'm gonna offer anything interesting. Anyway, I'm feeling very nostalgic for the old music right now. And also, I feel like I should mention, it's burning. Like it's burning up into the classic Apex colors. Oh, okay, here we go, here we go. I'm ready, I'm excited. I'm gonna maximize this. Maximize? Full screen it, whatever. Come on, let's go. All right. Okay, cool. Is there captions? I'm gonna put it on.
Freedom fighters should have fought for us.
Australian?
Some bones for me to land on.
Oh, wait. Show some respect for real Salvo badasses. They fought for our freedom so we could have a
bit. A bloody beautiful grenade!
Freedom! Is the next legend gonna be Australian? Is that like a good luck charm or something? Or like what? Oh! Just get a Spitfire and just. Okay. I have a feeling. Oh! A boxing match? Did this man just grow a mullet? Hold on. He grew a mullet! Good for him. They really like that grenade, huh? Bone Cage Championship. Also, I just have to say, I love the music. I'm probably gonna add this to my playlist. This isn't like my genre. Like rock and metal. Okay. I get that she's technically the antagonist in the Stories from the Outlands, but like. Okay, but who is she? What is her name? I know we're supposed to focus on him, but. Wally?
As a matter of fact, I am leaving the pit. kids. Leaving Salvo. Truce?
Leaving?
I'm, well, you're looking at Salvo's first fighter to join the Apex Bloody Games, eh? Give me the pin.
What? This?
Oh. They really like that grenade for some reason. Also, the art style they have for this kind of reminds me of Telltale's The Borderlands series. Tales from the Borderlands, whatever it's called. I don't remember. Whatever. Why would y'all... Okay. They are really weirdly possessive over this. Oh, he said goodbye to my arm.
Well, no need for a truce anymore, eh? Throw that out for me, will ya? It's a lost cause.
Okay. February 2nd? What day is it today? It's the 18th? I don't know how. That's in a few weeks, yeah, okay. Hold on, okay. I'm trying to understand what just happened. So, from my understanding, they found this little bomb thing, whatever, grenade, when they were young. And ever since, I guess it was like a good luck charm, because it's about the Salvo Freedom Fighters, who I guess are part of the reason why Salvo wasn't part of the Syndicate for so long. And then, they just kept fighting over it, over and over again, training it about. Okay, so I'm guessing he got a little greedy with this heist or something. And they grew apart. Bar fight, keep trading it back and forth. And I'm guessing this lady, because we know that the character is Wally, whatever his actual legend name is, I'm not very sure, but we don't know who this lady is, but she is definitely not happy about Salvo joining Syndicate. I'm guessing she wanted to be part of the Freedom Fighters, or she was a part of the Freedom Fighters, or maybe Wally here is also part of it. I'm not very sure.
As a matter of fact, I am.
Also, love that he just casually loses his arm. Doesn't seem to mind it too much. I feel like he would feel it pretty harshly. So they fought over the grenade once more, pulled the pin, she tossed it instead of putting the pin back in. Blew his whole arm off. I'm guessing she thought he was dead. Okay. But, like, I want to know why he was willing to join the games. Because you know that the games are run by the Syndicate. So unless he has, like, a bigger plan that we don't know of, I just wonder why. But yeah, inch the resting. Interesting. And then soon we'll get the, what is the name? Soon we'll get the Not Swords from the Outlands. After that, character trailer, and we'll also get the season trailer, the season launch trailer. So that's gonna be interesting. I wonder what his abilities are. Interesting. I know I was supposed to pay attention to him, but I'm not gonna lie, I was kind of paying attention to the lady a little more. Especially, like, how her hair got, you know, like, more and more, cool. I liked her hairstyle. Also, it is now my headcanon that this man is not straight. Like, well, actually, no. I don't know. I'm gonna have to ask my friend who has a mullet whether or not he has, like, a straight mullet or, like, a gay mullet. Because right now, I'm feeling he might be rocking a gay mullet, but I'm not very sure. We'll have to see in-game, and also the trailer. But for now, I'm gonna say that he's gay. Anyway, yeah, thank you guys for watching the video. I know that I couldn't provide much analysis, it was just me being mostly confused, just kind of keeping up with stuff. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I hope that y'all are hyped about next season, because I kind of took a break at the start of the year. That's why y'all haven't been seeing Apex videos, and then also, you know, stuff happens, life happens, so, you know, I've been staying away from Apex because I need to, like, chill out and find something that's not so competitive. But yeah, I hope next season's fun. I'm guessing we're gonna stay on Olympus and they're just gonna do a map change. Hopefully, you know, they're not gonna, like, global warming the whole thing and just make everything so sad and depressing like like in World's Edge. But yeah. Yeah, okay, cool. Hope you guys enjoyed. Like, subscribe, share if you wanna. Of course, you're never under any obligation. And as always, see you next time. Okay. So I know I said goodbye already, but I just wanted to look at this real quick because I didn't realize they put up the new season page. But it seems like we're gonna get orange. So that's interesting because we had, let's see, so it was red, blue, white, black, gold, purple, blue, like teal, and now orange. So that's interesting. That's interesting. So we have season 8 Mayhem. I'm guessing. Okay, so Fuse is the new guy. Let's see. Fuse doesn't lack confidence, but he often lacks a plan. He's a blow up first, ask questions later kind of guy. Okay. Interesting, interesting. And then we're getting a new gun, which is cool and quirky. It says, introducing the 30-30 repeater, Salvo's most popular weapon. This lever-action rifle picks apart the opposition with hard-hitting rounds. So I'm guessing this is either an AR or a sniper. If it's a sniper, I'm going to be tired. But if it's an AR, that's going to be interesting. Because it looks semi-automatic. But it also kind of looks like a shotgun. It looks like a shotgun. But they added a barrel and a stock to it. You know? That's interesting. Obliterated King's Canyon. Fuse entrance has dramatically... King's Canyon again? I thought we were... Dude, poor King's Canyon. Hold on. I know that there are teasers on King's Canyon. I haven't been playing, but I've seen them. But poor King's Canyon! This thing has gone under, like, what, 3 season changes at this point? Because it went under a change in season 2, 1 in season 5, and now in season 8. So Olympus is safe for now, but poor King's Canyon! What happened, my guy? What did he do to it? Like, you can't destroy that thing anymore. Like, Skulltown's already gone. I don't know what they're gonna change about King's Canyon, but they're changing it. That's interesting. Okay. Anyway. But yeah, this is the actual proper ending now. Sorry, guys. But I just had to add that. Sorry. Okay. Bye.